Many of the trace gases in the atmosphere are affected by the ocean. There's a strong sink in the ocean, and particularly in the Southern Ocean. We're very interested to know about that, and how much of the carbon dioxide that we're emitting from industry ultimately ends up sinking into the ocean. So overall on the planet, about a quarter of what we put into the atmosphere ends up in the ocean. But there's probably a large proportion that is taken up by the Southern Ocean. And if those processes were to change, that could have significant impact on how the composition of the atmosphere progresses over time. So one of the reasons why the Southern Ocean is particularly important is that the processes are potentially more efficient for uptake in that region. And these processes, it's a combination of biology and physics. So there's a solubility of carbon dioxide in the water, and it's more soluble in cold water, and so uptake's more efficient. And then there's the biology of the ocean, which draws in carbon dioxide through photosynthesis and growth. Yeah, we need to understand all these processes that govern uptake and emission. And carbon dioxide, for instance, is, as I said, more soluble in cold water, and there's a big sink process going on in Antarctica. So if that were to change, that could be quite important for the way that CO2 evolves. As we, if there's less being taken up by the ocean, then we might see more remaining in the atmosphere. So we need to understand the efficiency of that sink process. And if climate change were to change that efficiency and reduce it, it could in fact be quite a have a sort of potential impact, positive feedback impact, that would worsen the global warming